The Tony Stark Heads Up Display, or HUD effect, is one of the coolest video effects you can do. Man, I am claustrophobic. I would not make a good superhero. What does that thing even do? If you want to learn how to pull this effect off, stick around. I'll show you how. Jarvis?
Pepper?
Why is no one answering me?
Hit the subscribe button and click the notification bell to be part of the conversation.
Today, I really want to talk about how you can use layers to create an overall effect. This particular HUD effect is one that used a lot of layers. If you look right here in Movavi, in my project, you can see I have a lot of little layers going on. The very first layer I filmed was actually my face against a black background. Now, if you notice, it seems like it's sort of cropped and circled around my face. I did that very intentionally. When you click on your track in your upper left, you'll see the ability to control all of the things in this layer. To understand what I did, let me remove the crop and rotate and the highlight and conceal. You can see this was just me. I had a dark shirt on, I had put a black shirt on, and I had a black background around me that made it a little easier to do what I wanted to do. What I added was a crop feature that allowed me to focus in on the portion of my face that I really thought was important to this scene. The other thing I did was I used the highlight and conceal, and what this option does is it allows you to frame a box or a circle. You can see the different shapes you can create, square or circle, and you can really highlight the frame. Circle worked well for me because I was just trying to do the roundness of my face. Yes, I know my face is rounder than it used to be years ago, but this really allowed me to conceal and mask away the rest and create this sort of vignette effect that only focused on my immediate face. So to start, I had that track going on that allowed me to look like I was just speaking into this one highlighted circle. From there, what I did was I went on the internet and found some different images that I thought created this heads-up display technique. Now, you can go to places like pixabay.com or Adobe Stock Images that also has some great images that you can purchase. But I found this one online, and this image, let me turn off this other one so you can see, this image was just this sort of heads-up display that before I cropped it, looked like this. It was sort of a display layout that I found. Once I cropped the section that I wanted, I actually turned on the chroma key feature, and that eliminated the blue section from behind and allowed just the highlighted areas to show through. I also went up to the opacity and dialed it back to about 56. It was pretty bright, but dialing it back to about 56% seemed to give me a look that was a little more organic to what I was trying to create. So now I had this cropped layer that was just this sort of technical visual look, and I laid that over my original track of my face, me talking to the camera. And because I had used the chroma key to remove the color and let it show through, and also dialed out the opacity, that gave me this effect. If I had turned off the chroma key and dialed the opacity back up, it would be harder to see my face through this layer. So once I had the general feeling of what my face might look like inside of this heads-up display helmet, the thing that I noticed on Tony Stark's heads-up display was there was always a lot of things that were sort of moving in and out of frame as he was inside of the Iron Man uniform. So I started looking for even more things that I could add to this. This was another image that I found that was just sort of this weird circular design. It almost looked like a camera lens configuration, but I thought it helped frame the center of the shot. I added a little motion to it, and you can see it just sort of sits there, but I added a few flickering glitch effects to make it feel like it was pulsating a bit and moving. And this is really important to the layers that we add, is to create that motion. If you have a layer that you want to create some motion, all you need to do is click on that layer, go up to animation, and you can either drag down an animation feature onto that, or you can right click onto it, click on animation, and add a keyframe. And what that will do is add a spot in this particular layer that you can change the location of from where the existing shot is. And for every keyframe you add, let me add another one right here, and change the location of that keyframe, it will force that image to move in between the two. The keyframes are just where you want them to end, and Movavi fills in the blanks and moves this image from one location to the next. Now you can even do things like, let me add another keyframe here, right click, animation, add keyframe. You can actually grab that, grab the corners and shrink it down. That's how I created that zoomed in and zoomed out effect, because you can control it by clicking up in the right and resizing that image. So if we go back and look at the frames I just add, I move them around a screen, And then I had it resized, which made it seem like it's zooming out or moving away. But for my shots, what I had to do was kind of shrink and then come back out. Very simple. And that gave that center a pulsating effect. So looking at those three layers, my initial one was my face with this sort of digital display screen laid over it. And then this circle that wasn't very bright, but combined with the other two layers, it just sort of had this center effect that made it feel like I was within a helmet. Once I sort of had that center graphic figured out, the next thing I wanted to do was to add some other features that came in and accentuated things that might be happening within the control panel display of the helmet. This was another little digital graph that I found, and I brought it in for a moment and used keyframing to have it come into frame, sit up, and then I had it drop back down. Let me show you how I did that one. From this center section, if I were to add a keyframe, animation, add a keyframe, it gives you this window. The way I made it look like it was popping up is I grabbed the top and I dropped it down to the bottom. So what that does is it makes it feel like this is popping up and down and bouncing, but all I'm doing is actually grabbing the top and shrinking it. So with the motion I added, I just had it pop up, I had it sit for a few seconds, and then I had it pop back down. Now I did the same thing with other graphics in other areas. This was another piece I found over here, and I had it come from almost nowhere, pop into the upper left. I had it sit for a moment, and then I had it pop back away. If you want to figure out how to get these things to pop in and out, you can add a keyframe, and you can decide if you wanted to make it look like it disappears to nowhere, is to shrink that down to nothing. And that'll give you the effect of something popping in and shrinking back down to nothing. It's just controlling the size using the keyframes, and Movavi is figuring out everything in between. Some other ones I found were this little circular display, which if you look, I didn't keep this very high in opacity. This particular circle, I have it dialed back down to about 32 because I didn't want everything to be super bright. I wanted some things to be stronger, some things to be weaker. What that creates is a layering effect where some things are important in the scene and some things are less important. And I just found different places to put them. Some were in the upper right. But what happened was, is once I had all of these layers working together, then it started to feel like there was actually a lot going on inside of this helmet. I spent a lot of time trying to dial this in, getting the right combination of chroma key effect, opacity of the layers, and design of where I wanted to put things so that each layer made it feel like everything was happening inside of a helmet. Once I had this all put together, I actually shut off my main footage and I took all the rest of these and bounced them, which is really just exporting all of these as a project and bringing this back into Movavi. Once I brought it back in and everything was in a singular layer, I did some color adjustment. I was able to add a little chroma key onto it to pull out some of the darks a little more to let my lower layer show through and really tweak these layers in such a way that I could really get a more balanced effect that felt like something. Now here's the really cool thing. Once I had gotten all of these things into one layer, I started using that same keyframing to move the display every time my head turned. If my head turned to the left, I'd add a keyframe and slowly pull that layer over to the left a bit. If my head moved to the right, I'd add a keyframe and move that main display over to the right and started tracking with my face until it felt like when I turned my head, that display moved with it. And again, that's just a simple matter of putting the playhead where you want it, right-clicking, choosing animation and adding a keyframe. And wherever that keyframe is, I would relocate this to center on my face. And that allowed it to move with me. It took several keyframes and it took a bit of patience to make sure that the flow moved the way I wanted it to. But as you can see, it has a pretty cool overall effect that when I nod my head, it goes down. When I leaned in, I zoomed in. And every time I looked right or looked left, I would move that main screen with it. So it really felt like the helmet effect was moving with my head. This video was sponsored by the good people at Movavi. If you don't currently use Movavi, I'll post links down below where you can download the software right now and try these effects yourself.